Hey everyone, this is Girish Gopivar here. Today I'm going to try to use an application called WavePad. So in this, I just want to add some reverb to the song, a song which I sang yesterday. So I just searched in Play Store and found out this app called WavePad, and I think it's doing a pretty good job. I didn't test many apps. I got this. I was trying with KineMaster and all, but they are used for this video applications. So I just wanted an application for just for audio. So this is what I got. So it's easy here. So when you open, when you click on that application, this is how that application looks like. This is where is it? WavePad free. Okay, it's there on the second row, second application. So once you open that, it will come to the home page, home option. And I'm not going to tell you like how you can import it and all. I'm directly going to tell you how to add the reverb effect. Okay, you have to come to the fourth option, which is FX option, and then click on the second option over here. Echo, after echo, there is an option called reverb. Just click on that, and there are five knobs which you can change. So you can change them and fix them accordingly, and just listen to the click on this play button, which is below the back option. So once you click on that, it will start playing and show you how your the knobs, the values which you have fixed, like decay, pre-delay, diffusion, wet signal, dry signal, and all, how it is affecting the voice which you recorded. So I really don't know which means I just fixed these values, but these values, I don't think it's it should be like this is what you have to fix for every voice. No, I don't think so. Maybe there will be certain values, but you can like experiment and find out which one is like fine for you. And there are presets as well. You can use these living room, bathroom, auditorium, and hangar presets as well. You can test them, check it. So this is how you put some echo or a reverb to. Usually it is called reverb. When in music production, it is called reverb. Nobody says echo, I guess, but there is an option in this, there is an option called echo also. But this is how you put reverb to your voice which you have recorded in WavePad. Okay, and you have to just click on OK, which is there on the right top corner. Just click on that. That's it. Now you can save it. Okay, so this is how you do it. There is an option here. When you click on home, there is an option here, save file as. Now here you can name it. I'm going to name it as reverb tested. So I'm not going to change anything else. Okay, I think I will change this to MP3. Okay, so you cannot change the output format. You have to buy this thing, only then you will be able to change it. So it's okay, no problem. Wave is like the best quality option. Wave files are better than MP3. That's what everyone says. So I didn't do any test on this, but both of them when you are listening to it, both of them are similar, but people prefer wave files. So let it be wave, dot wave file. And now you can click on OK. That's it. That's how you put reverb to your voice. So hope this video was helpful to you. If you like the video, please do consider subscribing. Thank you so much and enjoy your life. Bye-bye. Take care.